Throughout the years, the Voltigeurs have lined up so many Anglophone players and therefore built a great English-speaking fan base. That being said, because most of our interviews are in French, we don't always get to know all of our players, even though they all have such great personalities. It's time to turn that around. I'm about to ride around town with the very first player to break the ice of this new concept. But before we go any further, let me introduce you to the 2020 Toyota Prius Prime. Sure, you'll notice its unusual exterior at first sight, but if you dig deeper, you'll find a car you can travel 1,035 kilometers with before stopping. And all of that with a car you can actually plug in the wall. It still amazes me. This technology may look like it's in the future, but it's happening right now. On the other end, my very special guest today is the future. Let's all enjoy his time in the queue, because you'll need to pay the NHL price to see him in not so long. That's Dawson Mercer. And for all these reasons, it's my great pleasure to have him on Hockey Players in Cars with Max, brought to you by Toyota Drummondville.
So whose car is it?
It's Toyota Drummondville. That's
that's the
sponsor for this this video.
Nice.
So you look at the shifter. It's crazy. I know. I had to figure it out.
Yeah, don't look too normal, eh?
No. I actually had to figure it out. How does it work? And if I want to put it in park, I have to put to press here.
It's almost like you're in a, you have to press it to put it in park.
Yeah.
That's weird.
Weird,
isn't
it?
It's almost like you're in a game.
Yeah.
click the buttons on the controller.
And had it been a day off, what would you have done?
Today?
Yeah.
I was supposed to have a school visit.
Oh.
But we had the ice, so I went on the ice, but no school visit tomorrow now.
So you don't get much time off then?
No, not too much. And then obviously you take the time when you get off to do some school work to catch up or stay on top of it. And then, so then it don't affect you when you have games or nothing. You don't want it to get in your way.
Yeah.
So kind of the daily routine of the same cycle a lot, but it's nice.
Did you ever come in that part of Drummondville? Not so much, I guess.
Huh? Not so much, a little bit. Frank's gym is just over there.
Oh, though. Yeah, right.
So I usually drive by here every time we go to the training.
So now we go on the dark side of the moon. You don't know what's over there.
No.
All right.
I've been in, it's my third year here. I know the routes around.
Know,
but
right.
No, it's, and when we had that scavenger hunt too, we were driving everywhere.
Oh, right.
Everywhere in Drummondville, so you kind of went to every corner.
Right, let's talk about that a little bit. Your coach has made up some kind of a scavenging hunt before the beginning of the season. What was that like?
It was actually a lot of fun. Like, we got in groups of four, the teams, and, well, one guy had the car, and you all hopped in, and you weren't allowed to split up, so everyone, and you had to find, given, like, hints and what was what we had to go take a picture of. All four of us had to be in the picture.
How'd you
find
team
it
do?
All? We I think we tied for second.
Oh,
I think out of like five, I think.
Not
so
bad.
We did okay, but Goats and them won, a hometown boy, so we kind of knew where everything was.
Oh, yeah.
So no, but it was a good, especially like not knowing all the guys at the start of the year, like obviously knowing them, but not like close.
Yeah.
It really like got. Everyone was having fun, laughing. It was a good time.
It seemed fun.
Day. Yeah, for sure.
What we saw on Instagram seemed fun.
Yeah, no. Everyone was smiling, laughing in all the pictures, videos. So yeah. it was a
good
cool
time.
Experience to have.
It seems like there's a lot of new players too. It seems like it was a good time to do something like that.
Oh, completely new group of guys. Only a couple of us returning from last year, so. Obviously, you just knew everyone from camp in the start of the year, and then obviously doing that really. Just little things like that bring everyone closer together, so it's a smart idea for the coaches.
Yeah, it seems like it's a good group of people. It seems like you have a good group this year.
Oh, no, yeah. It's a really good group. Everyone's really getting like along, and everyone just wants to win so bad, so I feel we really showed that, so it's coming out in the game too.
Yeah,
I feel.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's working hard, like it's paying like crazy.
Paying off, yeah.
Yeah. Are you a big Christmas guy?
Yeah, I enjoy
like Christmas,
yeah. It's fun.
And your family, what is Christmas like?
Get together, but it's a big like get together. Like obviously with all of us getting older and then moving our separate ways. Like I'm in Drummondville all year, so for sure it's a big thing. When I go home, I see my family, everyone. So basically, you do everything together, and then obviously when we come back, it's business here. But Christmas is a nice break to get away from and just clear your mind.
How far away is home again?
Oof. two and a half hour flight from Montreal.
Oh.
Then if you want to drive and take the boat, it's just way too long. I never did it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Like, I would have to drive from here to Cape Breton.
Okay.
Get on the ferry.
That's and a then long drive.
And then the ferry I would take would be the longer one because it would take me closer to home when I would get off the boat. So it's about, I think it's like 14 to 16 hour boat ride.
Wow.
And then I would get off and drive about like 2.5-3 hours home from the boat. So, or I can take the shorter one, like 6 hour boat, but then I have to drive like the 12 hours on the island. So
6 hour boat.
Yeah.
Wow.
That would be that's the short one.
I didn't even know.
Yeah.
He could like make Wilson, that long ferry.
Yeah. No, like Wilson took it when he come up. Like, he had to take the ferry because he got his car here. But no, I just took the plane.
That's crazy long.
Yeah.
So what is it you want?
I guess I'll take a hot chocolate. It's pretty cold outside.
Bonjour. Est-ce que je peux faire votre commande?
Oui, bonjour. Ça va être un moyen chocolat chaud, s'il vous plaît.
C'est complet?
Oui.
Merci.
So you changed the one thing in French for this part?
Yeah, maybe. I'm going to put some subtitles because we spoke in French.
Okay. Yeah, which is...
No.
What is Annie doing? She's walking by the, like, through the door?
I think she's going to be paying.
For sure everyone's inside looking at us like, what are they doing?
Yeah. With Charlie, when we when we did that,
yeah,
someone from the restaurant came out like, what are you filming?
No way.
Yeah. When Annie told them for it sure was Voltigeurs, yeah, it was fine.
But for sure they had some question marks around it.
Yep.
When you see someone driving around with three cameras and a cameraman following you.
Yeah. It felt really weird when I was driving around the empty car. It was just me and three cameras pointing at me. I felt pretty self-centered at that very specific moment.
Watching your every movement.
Yeah. People around was like, well, what is this guy doing? Driving around alone in his car with three cameras on him. No time to meet someone, right?
No, not too much. It's pretty busy, and it's nice to be going home anyways, like with Danny and them and Kaylin and the boys every night. It's a nice spot to live there, so.
All right, looks like
it feels like home there anyway, so.
Good.
It's good. You're in a race with them or what?
I know, right?
Good drag racing strip, right up the middle.